Now we are going to discuss about the equation of continuity. It is also called principle of continuity also. So what is the assumption to make this? Let us assume a tube of uniform cross section of finite dimensions like this. Whenever a non-viscous and incompressible fluid is flowing from one end of the tube to the another end. If you see the shape of the tube, here the area is A1 and A2, but there is a large variation in the areas of the tube. We can say that A1 is greater than A2. So as a whole wise, if you consider the speed of the efflux, means the fluid of the fluid when it is entering to the tube, here it is with less velocity. But when it is coming out in a form of efflux at A2 with greater velocity. That means the velocity of efflux is inversely proportional to the area of cross section of the tube. Velocity of the flux is inversely proportional to the area of cross section of the tube. So here it is, area is A1, at area A1 the velocity of the fluid is V1, therefore V1 is proportional to 1 by A1 and V2 is proportional to 1 by A2. A1 is more, that's why velocity V1 will be less, but A2 is less, that's why V2 velocity will be more. So, from this, A1 V1 is equal to constant and A2 V2 is also equal to constant. Therefore, A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Therefore, AV is equal to constant. So, what is this? When an incompressible and non-viscous fluid is flowing from one end of the tube to the another end of the tube, the product of its area of cross section and velocity of the fluid at each and every point is constant. So when an incompressible and non-viscous fluid flowing through the tube if suppose the product of its velocity and area of cross section is always constant. Of velocity of fluid element to the area of cross section is always constant throughout the path. This is called principle of continuity or equation of continuity. The next concept is the energy of a fluid which is in motion. Whenever a fluid is in motion, whether it is in a turbulent flow or streamlined flow, it possesses three different types of energies. First one, kinetic energy. Second one, pressure energy. Third one, potential energy. First, we will discuss about the kinetic energy. When a fluid is under the motion, each fluid element will move with the velocity v. Whenever an element changes to the velocity v, its energy converts from PE to KE. So the general expression of KE is equal to half mv square. But whenever a fluid is flowing through a tube, we should consider this kinetic energy per unit volume. Therefore, KE per unit volume is equal to half mv square by v. Therefore, half m by v square. Mass by volume is nothing but the density. Therefore, it is half rho v square. This is called kinetic energy per unit volume. The second energy is pressure energy. It is due to the pressure applied on the fluid element. So pressure energy, P is nothing but force by area. So F into L by A into L. So A into L is nothing but the volume. F into L is nothing but the work done. So pressure energy is nothing but the energy consumed per unit volume. The third one is potential energy. Potential energy, it is due to the position of the particle from a certain point. So with respect to the general equation, potential energy is equal to mgh, where h is equal to position of the desired point from a certain reference. So that's why its expression is mgh. So when we discuss this for unit volume, so therefore PE per unit volume, that is equal to mgh by v, where m by v is equal to rho, therefore it is rho gh. So the potential energy per unit volume is rho gh, pressure energy per unit volume is work done by volume, and kinetic energy per unit volume is half rho v square. These three types of energies, as a bulk, it is useful to explain the Bernoulli's theorem.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.